Welcome back to Dark Souls, everyone. This is Kay. You'll notice that I've got some fleshy bits here. I just used a humanity and kindled this bonfire to get my tenestus flasks. I also went through my inventory and found the set of armor that had the best poison resistance, so I'm wearing the gargoyle helmet and I think like the black leather tights, and then the ninja stuff, what is that called? The shadow armor and gloves. And the spider shield. So I thought I would take a look up here. I haven't been up this way yet. I was watching that last recording back, and I realized that it got really, like, laggy toward the end. And there's, like, some just crazy, like, lag spikes in the video. So sorry about that. I'm not actually sure what causes that. I don't think I was taxing the computer any more than usual. Like, I wasn't uploading or anything. We have a ladder here. And a treasure. Oh, is this the, is this, like, the bottom of that? Yeah, I guess this is the bottom of that huge, kind of cylindrical pit. I wonder what this was originally. It's kind of an odd, whenever I see grates like this, I think, you know, there's, like, gonna be sewage or something coming in this direction and maybe gathering here, and this would be a swimming pool for the for the blighted hollows. Alright, well, let's take a look at this treasure chest down here. This just screams trap, like, open chest. Huge enemy falls in the middle of this pit, and I have to fight him down here. Well, right next to a bonfire, so if that happens, so be it. Dragon scale? I guess not. Alright, what would dragon scale be under? Wait, don't I? Yeah, I had one of those already. Reinforced dragon weapons. I don't remember where I got that. You guys probably do. Since there's nothing else down there that I see. Nothing else over here that I see, because I can't go through that grate. Nope. Alright. So I've been thinking a bit about how I should approach this, you know, because that area out there looks clearly non-linear, and it's huge. I mean, it's like, I swear it's like the size of the rest of the areas I've explored combined. So I thought what I would do is kind of like pick a wall and just sort of follow the wall. So I think I might, like, follow this left-hand wall over here, just to get a sense of, like, the shape of the place. And then by the time I run out of Estus flasks, I'll try to get back over here and then come up with a new plan. I do have my poison healing things on the hotbar. Let me actually move them so they're right next to the Estus flask. These two, actually. And I'm gonna leave. I'm not gonna have the binoculars equipped. I'll just use the bow. Alright. So, first question. These little bugs. They look sort of like gnats or mosquitoes or something. So let me see if I can take care of them. Don't have a good aim. I also got this whip. I wanted to read the description of this whip. I saw the damage was not really impressive at all. But I thought I would just look at it. What am I doing? Come on. There. Has pretty good boost from dexterity. Leather whip, oh, not intended for battle. Virtually ineffective against armor and tough scales, but quite formidable against enemies with exposed skin. Loot. After those last couple of videos, I'm going to try to be really kind of careful and cautious here. No more just sprinting for loot. Getting myself into trouble. Just deal with the enemies slowly. Little things, aren't there? So I'm just gonna be poisoned, it seems like. Poison doesn't really seem like such a big deal. Like, my life doesn't go down very fast when I'm poisoned. So I think I'm just going to accept being poisoned for a while. Just means I'm going to have to be extra careful because I'm going to, I'm going to kind of be conserving the Estus flasks a little bit. But man, these things are... They come in droves. Ow. Okay. I'm going to try not to use an Estus flask until I get, like, the full benefit from it. My aim is so bad. I guess I'll just wait till they get close enough to target. So what is this all about? It looks like there's kind of a, like a ramp there. Oh, that's new. Let me let this guy get close, because I want to actually see what they do. What are your attacks? Some kind of... What was that? It looked like he kind of... Okay, you gotta jump. It looked like he, like, spat some kind of, like, black ichor at me. Treasure. Oh, nice. Green titanite shard. Whenever I get out of Blighttown, I'm going to... Oh, I'm no longer poisoned. I'm going to, go down to New Londa Ruins and, see about getting a magic weapon. I hope nothing is going to stab me in the back here. Oh god, what am I running into? Okay, I got a little bit of room here. See any treasure on any of these guys. So what is this? There's like a cave here. Oh, is this that? I think this might be like the roots of that tree that I kept seeing from up above. Oh, and there is treasure. A plank shield. Plank shield has pretty crummy stats. Makeshift shield built from wood planks provides minimal protection but at a cost of moderate humiliation. Yep, we're not going to use that. Is there anything else to see in here? Nope, just an empty room. So, continuing around this wall. Take a minute to kind of scan. Alright. I'm not even sure which, like, where I came from. Maybe, like, up kind of in that direction. I think that's another one of those, like, slugs. Okay. Nothing to see, really. Glad I bought all those arrows. Oh my goodness. I see six of them. Seven. My aim is so bad with this thing. Oh my god, really? Titanite shard. Nice. Large titanite shard. Oh, I'm gonna do some serious upgrades when I get out of Blighttown. Or maybe I'll find a blacksmith in here. Even better. Actually, I think I bought the upgrade boxes, so I might be able to do some upgrades just at the bonfire now that I think of it. I just can't do weapon ascension. There better be some good treasure over there with all these slugs around it. Ugh. It's mournful. My aim is mournful. I'm like a G.I. Joe bad guy. Or a stormtrooper, maybe. Actually didn't see what that was when I picked it up. Sorry. Could have been a soul. I'll just watch the video back when I hit a bonfire. Alright, so that section over there looks kind of self-contained, like this is the only way in. Oh, camera. I say camera as though it's like the game's fault, but it's just me accidentally rotating the camera. That kind of looks like maybe where I came in, because of all the torches. And then at the very bottom, yep, those kind of little spider bugs. There were a whole bunch of those, like right at the bottom. I've only got 23 arrows left. Plus 25 poison arrows. Oh, actually I guess I've got a whole bunch of arrows still. Okay, so there's that tree and the ramp where I got the plank shield. Yeah, that definitely looks like where I entered the level from. is alive or dead? It's like dead. Pyromancy, poison mist, and a whole bunch of armor. That has even better poison resistance. Like a ton of poison resistance. It also has... literally zero poise right now. Maybe I should switch out like one of these pieces for something else. Let me see. I could get 20 poise. Try this. No, that's too heavy. 20.2. Does this have poise? No. Alright, well, we're gonna be poiseless for a bit. I'm actually sure that the other stuff I was wearing probably didn't have any either. Maybe the gargoyle helmet did. Yeah, that's 8. Okay, we'll do this. Oh! God! Oh, that's the bonfire. It looked like dropped souls, which is kind of funny. Boy, I really hope that this recording isn't, like, super choppy. I probably should have checked after a couple of minutes. Oh, man. Uh-oh. Somebody invaded me. Oh, God, is this a player? Am I online? Oh jeez. Well, they're not wearing heavy armor, but that is a big weapon. Strong R2 makes them stagger. Oh my god. Okay, that wasn't bad, really. Oh, I got a lot of souls for that. Got a humanity and 3 portable humanities and a butcher knife, all sorts of stuff. right. Required parameter strength, which I don't have. And yes, I do understand that if I two-hand weapons, I get half again my strength toward the required parameter. So I could wield this two-handed because 16 plus 8 equals 24. But I would have to give up my shield. Oh, that's really heavy weapon though. 10 pounds. Maybe I'll give it a shot when I get back to a bonfire. Okay. So that was crazy. What was that? I feel like that wasn't a human invasion because I got like an item from it. Like I got the weapon. There's those kind of... I guess I'll get over to that eventually if I keep... Well, I don't know. I don't know if that's a dead end over there or not. So these guys are... They look maybe like those fat club-wielding, I forgot what you guys called them. I think somebody said they were like barbarians, and then somebody else said they were something else. Let's see if I can hit this guy. He noticed. Oh, there's more of them. This is so bad, my aim. Need to get closer. So what are they standing in front of? What is that? Looks like... Oh man, that whole mound is going to be an enemy, isn't it? Like that's going to be the eye right there. Alright, well. I had a plan to follow the wall, so that's what I'm gonna do. Oh, enemy. Oh god! They throw those. And there's more than one. Invincibility. Uh-oh, I'm trapped. Roll. Which one's hurt? That one's hurt. Oh my god. This is a good combat day though. This is a new day from my last recording. And I don't even think these guys have hit me yet. Alright, get him. Oh, that was close. Oh, get him. Oh, first hit. Okay. Well, that's a confidence boost. Do I have one of those? Atrocious fecal waste material. Throw at enemy to build up toxins, but also build up your toxicity. Although this stench makes it difficult to carry on one's person, turning an enemy toxic inflicts high damage over a period of time. Okay, that's on my hotbar now, I guess. I have poo on my hotbar. Is this where I was? Great club. Ooh, is this better than a regular club? 12 pounds. But that damage. Oh, that damage. 28, so to two-hand it, I would need, let's see, two-thirds of 28, which is like between 8 and 9. Is that right? No, it's 9.1 is one-third. Okay. Oh god, I'm just screwing up this math so bad. I need a couple more points of strength to two-hand it, basically, is what I'm trying to say. Okay, let's see if we can get just one of these guys. Starting from the left, you, come over here. Okay, so that's your range. Can't hit me. I'm too far away. I hit your boulder. What are you gonna do about it? Your lovely rock. That was supposed to be a jump. Nope. Belly arrows. I'm almost out of arrows. That was not good. I think this is too big to be a monster. Like, I know this game has thrown some big monsters at me, but this would be ridiculous if this whole thing were a monster. So. Oh god! Oh! That scared the hell out of me! Scared me so much. No, 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 no. Cancel. Go. Saw him running up this hill. There he is. Okay, back to the wall. And shortly back to the bonfire, because it's getting to be that time where I have no Estus flasks. Like a wall, an invisible wall, a hill that cannot be climbed. I see like a See, at the very top of the screen, there's like, it looks like there's a door in that wall up there. Like, not where I'm aiming, but above it. I wonder what that is. And so I think I'm pretty much like underneath, like Firelink, like way up there, like in front of me still a little bit. In fact, this wall in front of me, this kind of dark wall maybe is the, like one of the towers that goes up to Firelink. Is this a... Oh, that's another zone. Okay. There's some treasure out there. Blighttown. Okay, so now I think this wall should eventually take us back to the bonfire, right? Because it looks like we've gone like 3/4 of the way around like a big oval. Grab this treasure while I'm here. Another upgrade material. Alright, that'll do it for Estus. What is that? Okay, this is some kind of, like, wooden gears or something. Or like a, almost like a tank tread vertical. Oh, it's like a... Well, no, it's not a water wheel, because it's not picking up water. You know, I kind of want to explore that, but I... More than anything, I want to get back to the bonfire to get more healing. So I'm going to keep going this way. That's it? Yeah. Okay. Much better. Okay. So that was a very successful circuit of, the swamp, I guess, of Blighttown. We've got a whole bunch of souls from it, too, so I'm gonna, first of all, repair all my gear. And see what I can reinforce. I could do the raw battle axe. A lot of people in comments told me that the raw weapons were, like, not, I guess, very useful. Well, that they are surpassed by other upgrades, including just the regular one. So I'm kind of hesitant to, I could do my shield. I'm sort of hesitant to keep going on the raw path. Which is sort of a bummer. I mean, that's something that I don't think I should know. You know, that's not really a game mechanic, it's sort of like a what stuff is good end game, I think, falls into the spoiler category. So try not to tell me stuff like that. Cause I probably would have upgraded this. And now I'm not going to, so it does impact my gameplay. I think I am gonna do the shield once though. Even though I'm not using it right this moment. See how many times I could level. I can level twice and still have 4,000 souls, so let me do that. I'll do another intelligence. And... how about endurance? That'll put my stamina... Oh no, my equipment load. I was hoping it would put my equipment load at a nice, easy to divide by 4 number. But it does not. But it does give me... I'm gonna do hit points. Do health. Another point of health. And... Okay, no armor is upgradable. And I don't have enough shards to do the shield again. Okay. How long? Hold on, I'm going to tab out and see how long this recording has run. It doesn't say. I'm gonna cut this here actually, and start a new one and go explore that kind of contraption over there. So I'll see you next time.